Hello everyone, this is Tracy. I am back today sharing more painting DIYs of how I created these rustic farmhouse wood bunnies using some scrap wood. I was very encouraged and extremely honored and humbled by so many fellow crafters recreating the block bunny that I shared in last week's video. The Country Charm community was filled with these little bunnies, and I am so honored and encouraged to paint more with you. So I hope that you find some things helpful. Now, when I thought about making these bunnies, I was looking for some ears, looking around in my craft room, trying to see what I could use for ears. And I'm going to share a tip of something for another season that I came up with to make some little bunny ears. I am Tracy. I am a true craft junkie. I love to teach and inspire other people to create crafts with rustic country charms. So let me show you how I created these rustic farmhouse bunnies. Okay, as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, I was looking through my craft room to see what I could use for some bunny ears. I ran across these poinsettia flowers that I have left over. Now, these beautiful poinsettia flowers are from a vendor. I know I'm going to get questions about that. Where did you get those from? I had them in my stash from Christmas for the local gift shop that I work part-time for, and I thought that they would be perfect for these cute little farmhouse bunnies. Now, did you notice that bunny had a black nose on it? And so I wanted to make a farmhouse bunny, so I was playing around with the black nose. Well, then I was like, those look too much like mice. So I ended up going ahead and painting over those black noses and then adding some glitter to the nose for some extra sparkle and pizzazz. So I wanted to explain that part because in some of the video, you will see some of the bunnies with black noses, but that's the reason why. Okay, I started with these scrap wood. They're 2x4s. I will leave the size of the bunnies here on the screen so that you will know. I gave each of them 2 coats of white chalk paint. Then now I am going around the sides doing some shading with my gray paint, and starting out, I just dip half of my brush in paint, half of my brush in water, blend it on a paper towel, then I go around it and I give the shading like that. Now, since these were rustic farmhouse bunnies, I did a layer of gray, then I go back over it and give a layer of the brown because I like the combination of both of those for my rustic farmhouse little things here. And so anyway, for the cheeks, I like my cheeks to be more rectangle up and down. So I'm just using a stencil brush and stippling on some cheeks. And then I'll go back over and just give some white shading and also shade around the cheeks and make the eyes and just make everything so cute and fun. Thank you. Okay, I am calling these my picket scrap bunnies. And the reason is because this was an old fence, these boards were, that my brother and sister-in-law gave to me many years ago. And I just never did anything with them until now, because that is what I do. I'm such a craft hoarder. Anyway, so these boards were the long pickets. They were like, you know, for a fence. Anyway, so I just had my husband cut them down so that I could maneuver and handle them a little bit better. And so what I did is I gave each of them two coats of white chalk paint. Now, when I say two coats, I didn't go very heavy. I wanted it to be enough coverage, but I didn't want it to be totally solid. I hope that that makes sense. For my painted bunnies here, I have been using small wooden hearts, and it's just because I have an abundance of those left over from my woodworking days and my craft show days. So I have a lot of these on hand. You can get them anywhere unfinished. Wood pieces are sold like Hobby Lobby, Michael's, Joann's, any of those places have unfinished wood in different shapes and sizes. A furniture plug would work, a button, if you really want a heart and you don't have it, you can cut it out of foam board or scrapbook paper, cardboard, an old cereal box, fun foam, construction paper, or you can get, you know, someone to cut some wood shapes out for you. That would work as well. Don't stress about it. That is one of the things that I questions that I got is, what can they use for a nose? Anything. I've even seen people use old bottle caps. Search Pinterest, because you will get a ton of ideas. Anyway, so I'm just continuing here by just shading my bunnies, just adding some dimension and depth and making them really cute.